Okay, the last thing that you need to do is you've got your puzzle key parts in here. It should be fully dimensioned. And then what you're going to do is you're going to put your exploded assembly and your assembled view into here. Okay, so to do that, what you want to do is create a new sheet. So you can right mouse click anywhere, do a new sheet, and put the information in here. I'm not going to do that right now, but your exploded assembly, you know, the scale is probably more likely 1 inch equals 1 inch. Assignment, puzzle cube, the name is your name, and the part name is assembly drawing or exploded assembly drawing or assembly drawing. So we'll do this one as exploded assembly. So I'm going to fill this stuff out. Notice it's where it's located. Anyway, so what we're going to do, I've got the wrong sheet, but don't worry about that. I'm just going to leave it at this. Here's going to be a smaller one. And what we do is we come into here and we do our base view. And we're going to choose, it happened to come up to this one. So again, you got your view tool. You can choose whatever you want, isometric. Notice the scale is probably a little small, so try 1:1. That will probably fit okay. And then what we're going to do is then just leave it at that. Might have to make it smaller, bigger, whatever. You know, again, if you want like 3/4 of an inch, do 3/4 or 0.75. Either way. And then this is the only view you need is this one right here. So you just go to OK. Select it, so make sure you select it, which one view, and you only need the one. I guess I don't have it saved. We'll save it as such. Puts that in there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add in, if you look at, we're going to add in some information. We're going to create a parts list. So you go to annotate, come over here to parts list. And all you're going to do, if it doesn't pop up to this, you just select this item here. And then just leave everything what it is here, structured. You're going to change that to parts only. And everything else should be all right. And go to OK. And then you're going to place this in here. And then you can make this smaller if you want. Just go to these. And just move these in. Smaller. Hopefully these part numbers that you ended up calling the, because it these names, part numbers are whatever the name of the file is, blue, green block, whatever. And then you're going to move this into a position kind of away. A lot of times I put it down here next to this. Actually, you don't have this size paper, so I didn't load up my A size paper, so you just find a spot here. And then the next thing you're going to do, notice these are item 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So there's 5 of them. You come up here to balloons, and then you select on an item, and it'll put a balloon there. And then once you get 1 point set, just right mouse click, continue, and it'll put that, and it automatically numbers these because it knows from what. It numbers them. I think it has to do with which one was put in first. Oops. There we go. Do that. Continue. And you're done. Now notice this is sheet 6. We want this to be sheet 1. So what we do is you can drag, get out of this command or whatever command you're in. You can drag this up. And this should be sheet number 1. So now notice it's labeled sheet number 1. Sheet number 2. And so forth. Okay. Now last thing we want to do is do the assembled view. So we're going to right mouse click. Do a new sheet. Fill that information in. It's assembled view. So part name is assembled view. Or assemble. And And then this one here, we're going to choose the assembled. That one, that little icon, shows it all assembled. You put that in and change the scale, maybe 3/4 of an inch or whatever works. Bigger sheet than what you guys are. And what we want are the 3-4 standard views. Okay. And then we also want this back view here. So we want 4 views. Okay. We've got those. And then we can move these around however we want. And then what we're going to end up doing is with colored pencils, we're going to color these 2 assembly views. Okay. So what I want, if this view doesn't show all 6 sides, then you kind of want to delete this one and go to base view again, choose your assembled view. And what you want to do is then you want the back side. So like normal showing the front, right, top. So we want to show the bottom, back, and left. So what you do is you just kind of rotate this around so you see bottom, back, left. And make sure it's the same scale as this, like 0.75. And you're going to place that, just put it there for now. Okay. And you can move this one down into that corner there. So now you have kind of like what we did on the ISO grid paper. Do the all show all 6 sides. So we show the front, top, right side. This one we show the left, back, and bottom. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use colored pencils and color these the colors that you have before. And then we're all set. And this should be the last sheet, sheet number 7. So first sheet is a exploded assembly. In between are just the individual parts, and then your last one should be your assembled view. So we should have a total of 7 sheets. Then what we're going to do is then print those out and turn those in.